Hello and welcome to our presentation and demonstration of PitneyTrack Inbound by Pitney Bowes. In this video, we are going to cover the receiving workflow, deliver features, how to edit a package, and how to generate a report.
The interface of the PitneyTrack application has been streamlined to enhance your operational experience, to both simplify and make your operation more efficient. That is comprised of two components. So one is the desktop application. You can see on the right side of my screen. And on the left side of my screen, you see the tracking assistant interface. So at the top of the page, you have the receive and deliver function. Moving down, you'll see there's a quick receive function. Checkpoint packages, if that's enabled. And then below that is a snapshot of today's activity. Each one of these elements is actionable, where you can tap on a module and drill down into that activity. So for example, if I wanted to see all of my undelivered packages, I could tap on that section with my finger, and that will take me down into that particular section. And that is the same for all of the other modules in today's snapshot. So let's go ahead and take a look at the receive workflow so we can get an understanding and a feel for how that works. So if I tap on this icon, not unlike SenseSuite tracking online, you're going to see some familiar fields that you're going to need to populate. So starting with the tracking number, if you scan your tracking number, that's going to pull up and bring in that tracking number information. Now, if the application understands whether it's a FedEx or UPS package, it will automatically populate the carrier information. So next, you would need to fill in the recipient information, sender information if that's important, and you'll notice that the current status is defaulted to received since this is the received workflow. If that's the only information you need to save, you can hit the save button and it will record that package. Other information that's available is you can add comments. If a package is damaged, you can take a picture of that package and record that as well. I'm going to hit save here. And when we go back to the home page, you're going to see that that package is now showing up as undelivered and it's showing as received. Again, as described before, if I wanted to take action or take a look at that package, I can tap down into that module and see the information about that. So all I have to do is tap on that package. There's the information and I can update the information right there. Now, let's say I have multiple packages for an individual recipient. In PitneyTrack Inbound, now you can receive all of those packages at one time without having to do them individually. So again, I'm going to tap on the receive packages. I'm going to scan my first barcode. And then you'll notice in the upper right-hand corner here, you're going to see something called Scan More. So when I tap on Scan More, I can then start scanning all of the packages that are available for that recipient. And you can see them accumulating here in this section. Now, if I wanted to see them individually, I can tap on this arrow and it will drop down all of the packages that I have scanned for that individual. If I needed to add something specific to any one of these individual packages, you can tap on the three dots on the right and take that action. So I can attach a photo, I can edit the package, or if I've mistakenly scanned it, I can delete that package. If everything appears correct, I can close the arrow up here, and then I can add my recipient information just like I did before. But this time, I'm saving all 10 of these packages at one time. So I'll tap save. Now all 10 of those packages have been successfully saved. And again, if you come back to the package snapshot, you'll see them accumulate in the snapshot view. All of this information, by the way, is replicated on the website. So if we take a look at the website here and I refresh this screen, you're going to see all of those packages now accumulating on the website. Now you notice a difference here between the tracking, the undelivered on the website and the undelivered on the device. The reason you see that difference is the device is currently looking at 15 days worth of activity. So in the past 15 days, there were no undelivered packages until we scanned all of those. On the website, this shows all packages that have been undelivered. Now, if we're keeping up with those packages, for the most part, they should match. But if they're not, just like the device, you can click down into that section and look at each one of these packages and modify, edit, or take action on it. So that's a quick look at the receive function. Now we're going to take a look at the deliver function. Just like in receive, you're going to tap on the icon, and then you're going to scan your tracking number. And you can type in who you've given it to, who the recipient is. And then you can get your proof of delivery. You could also take a photo. Your organization requires you to take pictures of packages delivered. You can take that picture, and you can take up to 5 pictures per shipment. Save that. And now that information is saved directly with that particular package. And again, if we go back to the website and we look at those packages, you'll be able to see, if I drill down here, you can go in and see both the picture and you can see the delivery confirmation information. And all of that is stored in what I call this breadcrumb trail down below here. So you can see every step of the way from receipt to delivery, and every step in between. And there it is. If you wanted to deliver multiple packages at one time, I'm going to go ahead and tap on deliver again. And up in the upper right-hand corner here, you're going to see a switch for manifest. So you're going to tap on that switch to activate it. And then you're going to see a list of all packages that are on this device for which you can take action on. So in this case, if I wanted to select individual packages from this list, you can simply just tap on them. You can see the first and third package are selected. I could then tap on deliver to, get proof of signature, capture pictures for both of those packages, and then save them to the database. There's another way that you can save. So if you have many, many packages for an individual, so you can see in this case, I've got multiple. And if you've got multiple packages for different recipients, the first thing you can do is to find them in the filter using the filter option. And in the filter option, you have multiple ways to search for those packages: location, date, department, recipient, and given to. For this example, I'm going to click on recipient. I'll enter the recipient information in. I'm going to tap on done and then apply. So here you can see that I've got all the packages for Peter Evans listed here. And if there were other packages, they wouldn't show because that's the filter criteria that we're using is the recipient. Now, again, I could choose individual packages to deliver, but if I wanted to deliver all of these packages, I'm going to tap on these 3 dots over here and I'm going to select all. If you accidentally do that, you can tap again and tap deselect all. And again, then you can select individual packages. But for now, I'm going to tap on select all because these are all going to get delivered to Peter. I'm going to tap on deliver to. And again, I'm going to put in who I'm giving it to. So I'll type in Peter. Make sure I spell correctly. And then the status is going to be delivered. My location isn't changing, so I'm going to leave that as is. And then I'm going to tap on Get Proof of Delivery. So here's my proof of delivery for these packages. And now I'm going to get a different photo. I'll take that picture. And the great thing about this function is that this proof of delivery and photo has been applied to all 10 of those packages. So now once the uploading of the transaction is complete, and we can go over to the website version. So you'll see here, all of the packages that have been delivered now show in the package activity section. And you can see that every package has both the photo that was captured as well as the proof of delivery. And that is the same for every one of the 12 packages or 10 packages that we just received. So you can see that here. And that is a true time savings. Now, one of the great things about this interface is that no matter who is using, if you have multiple devices that are all connected to the New Haven site, regardless of who the user is, everyone will see the same information on their package snapshot. And that can become really handy, especially in a scenario where your mail center requires that all of your packages get delivered by end of day, if that is an SLA. Now, if you need to edit an individual package, there are multiple ways to get to that. So you can search, you can go to the Find a Package section, and you can select any one of these packages that are in the list. So if I wanted to change the carrier for this particular package and I wanted to make it Amazon, I can do that and save the package. And now that package has been updated. So that's one method for editing a package. And tapping on any one of these modules allows you to edit any package that's found below. So if I tap on the delivered, and let's say I take this first package and I accidentally delivered it. I really didn't want to have it delivered. I tap on the delivered status and I can change it to attempted. When I save that, that's now going to be reflected in the package snapshot section. And that's the same for any one of these fields or modules. I can tap on this, change attempted to checkpoint, save it, and now it appears in checkpoint. Now, if we come over here and we refresh the desktop again, you'll see it reflected there. And just like in the handheld, if I click down into the checkpointed, I can update the package details here as well by tapping on edit. Make my changes. So again, I'm going to change this from checkpointed to attempted, put it back in the attempted, save it. And now when I go back to the main screen, there it is. To view and visualize your inbound package activity on the website, you can come over here and click on View Package Tracking. And that takes you into a main menu or a list of all package activity that's taken place within your organization. There are multiple things you can do here, including sorting information. So you can sort by all locations or individual locations. You can sort by package type or by status. You can add or remove individual columns of information to your view. And then finally, you can search on individual packages in the search window. To export any of the information you see here, you can move your mouse over to the export button. And when you click on that, you can see a variety of ways to export your data. So CSV, comma separated value, PDF, which is an image of the data. So it's not necessarily, they're not individual records, it's like a picture. And then finally, Microsoft Excel format. So if we decided to take a look at visible data, let's do that for the PDF. And we want to include our package history. And if we wanted to see the signatures in there, we could do that here for PDF. And now that information is moved into the exported data category. So if we tap on that, you'll see that my request for that has been made. And how do I know that the request is still processing? Well, if you look at the status, specifically shows that it's processing. So if you wanted to see today's activity, click Export Visible Data. And we're going to include the package history, the site name, and the contact custom fields, if there are any. Now, the difference between here and the PDF, if you wanted to see a recipient's signature, you would use, that would be a case for using PDF. But if you're just looking to manipulate the individual records or look at those individual records, you can use CSV or Microsoft Excel. You can see up here, it says the report is being processed. And if we click on exported data, we can come in here and see that the file has actually been successfully exported. Now to take a look at that, click on the download button. You're going to see it appear down in my screen here. And if I open it, you'll see all of the information here. If I just wanted to see a PDF, you can see I have a PDF version downloaded here. This I did include the signatures. And here, if I click on the PDF and open that up, that's going to show me a picture, again, of those columns. And here you can see the picture of the signature itself.
Thank you for viewing this demonstration of PitneyTrack Inbound by Pitney Bowes. For more information or for support, please visit the PitneyTrack Inbound site pictured here, and we'll provide the link in the description below. Thanks again for taking time to learn more about PitneyTrack Inbound.